Hey guys, what's up? Jedi here, and today we're going to be going over how to transfer creative skills to Arena. So before I can go over how, I have to go over why you might be better in creative than you are in Arena. The first reason is lag. In creative, you have lower ping and higher FPS. This means that your building and editing feels way more responsive and you feel more cracked. The second reason is stakes. When you're in creative, whether you're doing build fights, box fights, or realistics, the stakes are much lower. If you die, you just wait 5 seconds and you're in the next round. Compare this to dying in-game, where you're losing arena points or even tournament games, and you have to waste 2 or more minutes before you're in the next one. Add onto this the time and effort required to loot up, and you're losing a lot with each death. So, when you fight in arena or in tournaments, you'll feel more pressure as a result of these higher stakes. First, let's address the responsiveness. Honestly, there isn't much you can do about the ping difference between creative and arena. There are things you can do to lower your ping in general, but there's still going to be that difference and it's just something you're going to have to get used to. FPS, on the other hand, can be dealt with. The easiest way to fix the FPS difference is to turn on performance mode. Performance mode in general increases FPS and makes your game more responsive. You just have to bear with the mobile graphics. It can also help to cap FPS at a good number that you can get in both creative and arena. For example, if I get 240 in creative but only 160 in arena, I would cap my frames at 160 so that I don't feel much of a difference. Go try these things out and let me know what you think in the comments below. Now, let's talk about the second issue, which is pressure. This can be dealt with by playing. Now, I've always said that realistics aren't helpful because, I mean, when was the last time you played a realistic like you would in-game? Probably never. With that being said though, realistics are a good practice. This is because the skills learned can be transferred in a real games. Imagining that you're in realistics when you're fighting in the actual arena can be super helpful. And if you're able to get into this mindset, you're going to be able to start playing with a lot more confidence. I tried this out myself, and so I was basically playing realistics nonstop for weeks. And whenever I went into a real game, I had a much easier time because I could imagine myself taking those fights in the realistic map. Another way to build confidence through experience is to just straight up get the experience you need. This can be easily done by literally ignoring your arena points and just taking fights. This was something I did last season when I was struggling with this exact problem. After losing a ton of points, I started to make ends meet and even started gaining points through keying, because I was learning from every fight I took. So far in this video, I've honestly gone over some pretty basic tips that I know a lot of people always talk about. So now we're going to switch things up a little bit and I'm going to talk about some things that I personally did to get better at real game fights. The most important thing I changed was playstyle. When I had smoother frames and better ping in creative combined with the confidence, I was playing like a madman and using mechanics to just crank speed in fights. This playstyle never worked out in game. So I adjusted and started playing slower and more methodically. Basically, I went from playing like clicks to playing like Epic Whale. This helped me a ton because the slower playstyle was easier to use in game. And doing this allowed me to easily practice my real game strategies in creative. While this may not apply to everyone, if you think you're struggling in arena because you can't make plays at the same speed as you can in creative, maybe try changing up your playstyle a little so that it becomes easier to transfer. Now I'm going to address the creative warriors out there. In real game, cranking out a god retake with 5 edits isn't going to be that useful. Having the mechanics to do those retakes is good, but you need the muscle memory to do moves that you'll need in game. An example of a move that is super popular right now is the Reek Box, which is a move I've showed up in a lot of videos. The muscle memory and crosshair placement required for this move, for example, is completely different from a physics retake. So make sure you're picking up on what moves are useful and practice those as well. Remember, just because you have good mechanics in general doesn't mean you're going to be able to do every move better. For example, someone with kind of bad mechanics who practices this one move every day is going to be able to pull it off in real game when they're under pressure much better than someone with better mechanics who has no practice. So keep these principles in mind when you're going into real game next time, because you want to know what moves you need to practice so that you can apply those in real fights under pressure. That's going to be it for my video on transferring creative skills to arena. If you enjoyed or learned something, don't forget to leave a like. Subscribe to my channel for more Fortnite competitive tips and tricks, and use code JEDI2X in the Fortnite item shop to support me. Thanks for watching as always, guys, and peace.